folks. Larry, Mobile Tech, here with CannedHamTrailers.com, and it's time for another update on the 66 Super Shasta. Now today I'm going to update you on the work that's going on the Shasta here. Also going to update you on the progress of the 47 mainline, the Silver Lodger. I also want to talk a little bit about my upcoming live streaming classes for my patrons. So let's go ahead and get started on the Super Shasta. Not much has changed on the outside since the last time you were here, but we've got some work done on the inside. And I think if you remember from my videos, we also got the two fantastic fan vents in, and we got the refrigerator installed. So it was in the hole before, but it wasn't hooked up. So let's go take a look. Alrighty. Yeah, I've been playing around with where the water tank needs to sit. And so pretty soon here, we're gonna be starting the plumbing. In the meantime, I got the bunks taken care of. They're completely installed and paneled now. So those are all in. There's the rear bunk. And here's the forward bunk. This trailer will actually sleep 8 people. I mean, that's if you want to put 8 people in a, you know, a 16-foot box. The length of the trailer is 18 feet, but the box is only about 16 feet. Just a little less than that, actually. So if you want to put 8 people in here, you can do so. Don't know that I'd want to sleep in here with 7 other people, though. But we're about ready to get started on the plumbing. And before I do that, I want to get the countertop finished with the new Formica. That's going to look great. And get the sink in so that I can see where my faucet's going to sit and all that. And then we can go ahead and start the plumbing. I've already installed the water heater. It's permanently installed now. And you can see one little problem I have here with the output of the water heater. And I knew all along that this was going to be a little problem because it sticks out. But not to worry. I'm just going to have an indentation on the inside of the door that will fit over this, and we won't have to worry about that. So the reason that happened is because the cabinet is still the same size as it was, but the water heater is bigger. It used to have only a 6-gallon water heater. But we went ahead and put a brand new Atwood 10-gallon water heater in here. So that's the only little problem I have to deal with. Just got to hide that plumbing and everything will be fine. I already got the gas line run for it. So you can see right there. It's a little dark in here, I know. Little problems like lighting are going to be solved pretty soon here. But I like the idea that the bunks are in. They're out of my way now. The fantastic fans are in. There's one. That's the one for the center of the trailer in the key sheet. And then also we have one in the bathroom. And the one in the center here has a rain sensor. So if it starts raining, it closes and shuts the fan off automatically. The one in the bathroom, we didn't need that convenience because it's right over the shower, as you can see. So if it stayed open and started raining, it would be really not a big problem. The water would just fall into the shower. So that's it for the inside, except for the refrigerator. As you can see, I paneled the front door of the refrigerator. I also turned it around. It was opening in the other direction, but now it opens this way for convenience. So I'm really happy about that. All right, so it's got the paneling, so it kind of blends in. All you can really see is the outline. All right, so that's in. The heater is in. The water tank is about to be installed. That's going to be where I start, that and the countertop, so I can get all the plumbing in. So that's what's next on the list, and we're going to be starting that today. And I'll take you through with some of the plumbing. I won't show you all of it because it's pretty repetitive, but I'll take you through with some of it so that you see how that's done. Now, moving over to the main line, as you can see, quite a lot of work has been done on this one. That was a real trick, getting the wrap off. The wrap is the basically the ceiling, see, but the ceiling goes all the way around to the bottom, and the same thing in the front, and we call that the wrap. I have a video up of a dress rehearsal for my classes, and it's a 2-hour long video, but you can fast forward through some of the stuff that doesn't interest you much. But I used this trailer in its current condition to give you an idea of the anatomy of a trailer, of a vintage trailer, which I'm going to be teaching in my classes. I'm going to be going into great detail on that. I just gave sort of a sneak preview look at what my classes will be like. And they're going to start in 2 weeks. So if you want to get involved in the classes, they're live streaming classes with a chat room so you can talk and ask questions live. In order to take part in that, in the classes, you'll have to be a patron. So there's a link below here in the information box. Just click on Show More and there'll be a link there for Patreon, and you can go there and sign up. It's a minimum pledge of $5. That's $5 a month, so that's really nothing. And not only will you be able to be involved in the classroom, but you will be able to watch the build on this 47 mainline. Because all the regular viewers are going to see our updates like this one. They're not going to see the actual work, but the patrons will. So as you can see, I've got it down to nothing but walls and cabinets now. And the next thing that's going to happen is the walls are going to come down and get rebuilt and reattached one at a time. So something you'll notice about a solid plywood trailer, the framing is exposed and on the inside. There's no paneling covering it up. All the framing is exposed. And there's really no framing on the outside. There's just some plywood strips to give it a little bit of a quarter inch space for insulation. And that's about it. But yeah, we've really got a lot accomplished on this trailer. And I can't wait to start getting the walls off and getting those rebuilt. But I'm spending most of my time on the Shasta currently because I got to get it out of here. So we're getting very close to being done. I'm going to be working on the windows. I'm going to be working on the plumbing and the countertop and the table. That's the work. And I'm going to be doing all that simultaneously because there's things that need to dry, and there's things that, you know, it's kind of thing. It's a lot of little detail work. So as you've seen in my previous builds, that's pretty much how I do it. I'm working on a lot of things at one time. So there's your updates. And again, I want to mention the Patreon because you'll really get a lot out of that. A lot of extra content, like the build for this trailer and other things that I do, and the classroom. And you'll gain a lot of information in there that you normally wouldn't get from my videos. I try to show as much on my videos as I can, but I want to interact with my viewing audience so I can help them individually with their trailers, and the classroom is where we're going to do that from. So make sure you click on the Show More button down below and join up as a patron, and we'll see you in class. So right now I'd like to go ahead and thank all the people that have signed up on Patreon and who are supporting me now. It's just great. I really appreciate it, and I couldn't be starting the classes without you. We need to get more, but it's a good start, and I want to see it grow, and the more people that we get into it, the more I can do for you. So thanks a lot for your support. It's really appreciated. And let's hope that we keep growing. So this is Larry, Mobile Tech from CanhamTrailers.com. We'll be seeing you soon. Keep on trailering and be safe out there. See ya.